أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
إن الحمد لله، نحمده سبحانه وتعالى ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه، ونعوذ بالله سبحانه وتعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهدي الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، الذي خلق فسوى، والذي قدر فهدى، والذي أخرج المرعى فجعله غثاء أحوى. ليس لنا رب سواه، ولا نعبد إلا إياه، مخلصين له الدين ولو كره الكافرون. وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدًا عبده ورسوله، وصفيه من خلقه وحبيبه، بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة، ونصح الأمة وكشف الغمة، وتركها على المحجة البيضاء، ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك. فصلوات ربي وسلامه عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. يقول المولى عز وجل في كتابه العظيم بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. أما بعد، my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, إن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, first we welcome all the Hajjij and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept their Hajj and accept their dua and accept the good deeds they did, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept the steps they take to Mecca and turn it back to the home safe, insha'Allah Rabbil Alameen. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, in the Eid time, we see a lot of police people around us, support and help. We saw them kindly smiling in our face. They help the children. And if you see it sometime, they go down, they tie the shoelace for our children. They welcome us, they congratulate us for the Eid. But we have some issues among our families. When they returned back to the stations, so many phone calls to interrupt them, we have problems in our houses. What's our problems? Believe or not, compare. But what happened to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his companions? Nothing. Fighting from nothing, mainly from the Muslims people. We have an officer who was talking about it, and he's a Muslim. And he gets sad. He says, all the calls in the same day of the Eid from the Muslim brothers and sisters. It's a musibah, but the real musibah that we stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we don't know where we will be, in Jannah or not. This is the real issue. This is what we're looking for. That's what we need. Not what happened in the dunya. Fighting for food, for money, for clothes, for a day off, to go for vacation, to go there and there. This is our problem. But where are we at from our deen? The Jum'ah, you see how many people? And the masjid will be full before we end the khutbah. But in the Eid time, thousands of people. So we have Muslims, but they don't like to attend the fard, but they love to be in the sunnah. But if they attend the masajid, you will understand the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and when they can control themselves before they call 911 and they say they are Muslims. We don't have that before. So my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, if we look at the masa'ib and the kalimati that happened, we look at all the prophets, it happened to all of them, but they lean and depend on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They try many days, many months, many years. When they fail, they never complain. They never have a problem. They only returned back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. 950 years, Sayyidina Nuh alayhi salam facing a problems, a real problems, which we are looking for, how we got closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, how we love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He fell with his people. Then he returned back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said to him, قَالَ رَبِّي لَا تَذَرْ عَلَى الْأَرْضِ مِنَ الْكَافِرِينَ دَيَّارًا. Don't let anyone anymore in this earth. إِنَّكَ إِنْ تَذَرْهُمْ يُضُلُّوا عِبَادَكَ وَلَا يَلِدُوا إِلَّا فَاجِرًا كَفَّارًا. If you leave them in the earth, all the generation after that being among the kafirin. But he didn't complain about his family. He always asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide his family for the righteous, until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tell him about his son, he's not from you, leave him alone. Look at Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam, and we all know the stories. By the time of the people going to the Hajj and we go through the stories, how he controlled himself, never complained when they tried to put him in the fire. Look at him when he put his wife and his child in the desert with no food over there. This is a real musibah. You leave them and you don't know what will happen. Look at Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam. While you are yesterday, people fasting and people continue today for the Ashura. Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam, when he was a baby, and this is a real issue, a mother scared that her son got killed and she's getting order from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to put him in the box and throw him in the river. He died no matter what. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala watched him by his eyes. He said, if you are scared, throw him in the river. And I will watch him. I make sure he will return it back to you. And did. It happened. But when he grew inside the house of Pharaoh, and he got a problem, and he left, and he come back, and he stand before, we all know the story. What happened to Musa alayhi salam? Did he complain? He always depend on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he left Egypt. And Musa at this time, when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam entered Al-Madinah from Mecca, he saw the Jewish people, they are fasting this day. This is the same day he left from Egypt and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved him. This is the same day that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved Musa alayhi salam from Pharaoh. Then he said, "Ama ana awla minkum bi Musa." He's my brother. And he swear if he's alive for the following year, he will fasting the 9th and 10th. He just want to make extra day or two, so he cannot be like the Jewish people. Because he loved Musa alayhi salam. Sayyidina Yunus, when he ran away from the difficulty he faced inside the ocean, he didn't say anything more. He's dependent on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, I made a mistake. La ilaha illa anta subhanaka inni kuntu min al-zalimin. So this is the real issue problem. What their problem? They invite the deen, they make the da'wah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the people reject it. But our problem is different. It's a small issues. If we understand while leaving the dunya, no matter what, my dear brothers and sisters, we will never do that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, الَّذِي أَحْسَنَ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ خَلَقَ وَبَدَأَ خَلْقَ الْإِنسَانِ مِنْ طِينَ. He created everything subhanahu wa ta'ala in the best way. Then he started creating al-insani from mud.
After he did everything for you perfectly, then he starts created the human being. وَبَدَأَ خَلْقَ الْإِنسَانِ مِنْ طِينٍ ثُمَّ جَعَلَ نَسْلَهُ مِنْ سُلَالَةٍ مِنْ مَاءٍ مَهِينٍ. Then he made the generation from them, from Adam and Hawa. And what happened? وَخَلَقَ لَكُمُ السَّمْعَ وَالْأَبْصَارَ وَالْأَفْئِدَةَ قَلِيلًا مَا تَشْكُرُونَ. He created for you your ears, your eyes, and your hearts, but not so many people thanks Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for that, but He gave it to you for a reason, to think about Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because everything comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. يُدَبِّرُ الْأَمْرَ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ إِلَى الْأَرْضِ ثُمَّ يُعْرَجُ إِلَيْهِ فِي يَوْمٍ كَانَ مِقْدَارُهُ أَلْفَ سَنَةٍ مِمَّا تُعُدُّونَ. Everything comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the earth, and everything will return it back to Him. So any order come, anything happen to you, anything is touching you, it's come from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and He will see how is your reaction, how is your action about it, and then everything will return it back to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give us example as a believers. For the disbelievers, when they say, if we are doing something wrong in the earth, are we going back to a different people? But they will be among the kafirin because they don't believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But people of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is different. Allah accepts your dua because you pray all the time. Remember, this is two angels. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put them for you. And when you do a good deeds, they write it right away. A bad deed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give them the order to wait. Because you know this person, he's going to pray. He's going to make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala so Allah can remove the sin before He write it for you. So my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he faced a lot of problems. As all the other prophets. Imagine he is the prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and he loved Mecca. Mecca, the place he born in it. And then he got in the order to leave because of the hardship he find it there. Because the Quraysh people didn't like him to be in Mecca. He left sad. But when he left he said, look what happened to him. He lost his daughters. Lost his son, he lost his wife, he lost his uncle. All of these things happened to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But he was among the sabirin. الَّذِينَ إِذَا أَصَابَتْهُمْ مُصِيبَةٌ قَالُوا إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَجْعُونَ. We can't sleep the night and the morning, you get the phone calls. One who you love, he passed away. You get sad. But where is the sabr? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned those people who get the sabr, أُولَٰئِكَ عَلَيْهِمْ صَلَوَاتٌ مِّنْ رَبِّهِمْ وَرَحْمَةٌ وَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُهْتَدُونَ. So he faced all of that sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to establish the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the fighting for the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not for the dunya. Allah give permission for the Muslim people. If you're not happy with your wife, let her go. If she's not happy with you, let her go. But we have to control ourselves if we have children among us. Because our biggest problem, our fighting together because of the kids. They need something, they go for one parent and the other against it, and that's how the problem starts. So we need to control ourselves. Brothers, you are the man. You are the one who can, you can control yourself. And sisters, she has to understand what's your ability. Inside the house, what you can do. Don't look at the others. Look at yourself and your husband and your family and how you're going to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The time of Ashura, it's a memory for all the Muslim people, my dear brothers and sisters. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who is the first example, all his family, the family of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they working for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He never start with the people, he start from his family first. When he migrate from Mecca to Medina, he put Ali ibn Abi Talib in his bed. One of his family. But when he died sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, look at his generation. Sayyidina al-Husayn radiallahu anhu warda. I'm giving you the smallest stories from the house of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam so you can compare it, but the musibah you have it in your dunya and you see how is it. But you will think about it, and if you think and you see it, you see your calamity, your problem in the dunya, it's nothing. Sayyidina al-Husayn radiallahu anhu warda in the day of Ashura, who is moving toward Karbala in Iraq. Because he got a call from the Iraqi people, from the Karbala people, come and save us from Yazid and Muawiyah. We don't like them. Well, in his way, but Muslim is smart. He always think. We learned it from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So he sent to Muslim ibn Aqil, and who he is? His cousin. Go over there and check. How is the situation over there? When he went there, he said, who give Mubayya to al-Husayn? Who extend his hand to Sayyidina al-Husayn? 4,000 people within few days, they join him. Zayd, he called Abdullah ibn Zayd. He said, you have to go and stand for that and go and fight with them. But already the 4,000 people surrounded the house of Abdullah ibn Zayd. But he was very strong. He's a fighter. And that's known, the Muslim people, when they fight, they are very strong, they don't scare. Mainly, the people, what you call them now Shia, the blood is nothing for them. So he told them, if you are not moving, I'm going to all the room, all the troops, everyone will come, I'm going to get rid of all of you, and we'll go to Mecca and Medina, and we're going to kill everyone over there. So he scared them. The scholar said, from the time of the sunshine to sunset, the 4,000 people disappeared. They left Muslim ibn Uqayla alone. So they took him as a hostage. But he told them to Abdullah ibn Zayd, just I need to send one message and the last message to Sayyidina al-Husayn. The scholar said over 500 message reached Sayyidina al-Husayn to stop, not to go there, but he insists to go. His word is, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if you like the dunya or akhirah, he said, bal rafiq al-a'la, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Jannah. And I'm going the same way. When he got the message from Muslim ibn Aqil, don't go to Karbala. Those people, they will never support you. They run away from me. And I don't like things to happen to you, stay there. But he's in his way, he insists to continue. What happened to Sayyidina al-Husayn when he reached there? The fight starts. First, they kill Muslim ibn Aqil in the day of Arafah. Remember the days. The day of Arafah. And we have the first day of the Eid al-Adha, Saddam Hussein. If you are with him or not, but it's a mark for the Muslim people. In the day of Arafah, they killed him. Sayyidina al-Husayn, he reached there. No negotiation, they start fighting. They ask him to go back and leave. He insists to continue the fight going on. They kill everyone. But Shambar, one of the people who take his soul and get off the neck of Sayyidina al-Husayn, and he separated from his body. You know whose body is it? Al-Husayn, the son of Fatima al-Zahra, the daughter of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the son of Sayyidina Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anhu arda. This is the real musibah. Not fighting for money or the dunya, my dear brothers and sisters. They put their life for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But for us, small issues will make it a big. We think we're going to live in the dunya forever. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned Surah Al-Sajda about the mujrimun, the disbelievers. When they saw everything by themselves, they would say to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, أَبْصَرْنَا وَسَمَعْنَا فَرْجِعْنَا نَعْمَلْ صَالِحًا. Now we understand, we can see everything. Can we go back and we do the righteous? But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he say his words, لَأَمْلَأَنَّ جَهَنَّمَ مِنَ الْجِنَّةِ وَالنَّاسِ أَجْمَعِينَ. I would fulfill the hellfire from the jinn and the people who disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I mentioned that today, my dear brothers and sisters, because the problem we're facing as a Muslims, the masjid is your place, my dear brothers and sisters. Come to your lectures, listen. You have convention coming up. Read, understand. You will warm your heart when you open your mushaf. This is the real thing can kill any problem you have. Don't wait. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he taught Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam the wudu, and Jibreel alayhi wa sallam show him how to make the wudu. And do you know the importance of the wudu? Is a water can shut off the fire. If you are in wudu, if you come to your salam time, you see everything is gone. But if you don't pray, you don't do wudu, you don't pray, you come to your salah and you have the problem, the shaitan will get you. الشَّيْطَانِ يَعَذُكُمُ الْفَقْرِ. The shaitan will be behind you. He will get you. But ask yourself, if you pray the Isha and you leave the masjid, how is your feeling after you read the Quran? Ask yourself, if you open the mushaf and you start reciting one ayah and understand it, how is your feeling? Wallahi, it's big difference. But because we are ignore all of that, we have the problem. A small thing in our houses, we try to stand in the front of each other, assuming the police or 911, they will take a side of one of us. They make fun of us as a Muslims. So ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to warm our hearts and to correct our houses from the masa'ib, and let our kids come closer to us. Let our wife understand the situation. The brothers control themselves. This is the best thing, my dear brothers and sisters, to let the family confirm as firmed, and this the family is in the state of the Islam, understand the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah li wa lakum wa lisa'il mu'minin. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. So my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, our heart belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Your lifetime, it's in the hand of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قُلْ يَتَوَفَّاكُمْ مَلَكُ الْمَوْتِ الَّذِي وُكِّلَ بِكُمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala assigned angel to take your soul and my soul in time, and we're gonna leave the dunya. What's left is your good deeds. A son or a daughter, righteous, they make dua for you. Imagine if you are tough with them in the dunya and they don't like you. Do you think they're gonna make dua for you? If you hurt your wife, you think she's gonna remember you, she's gonna make a dua for you, or she's hurting you? Same thing. You're going to say, alhamdulillah, she's gone from my life. But take the example of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The real musibah happened to him and his wife. When they say, Aisha, she did something wrong. And he got upset when the people pointed to Rasulullah, that his wife did something wrong. And she was demanding Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala until Allah free her from the skies, from the seven skies. This is Aisha, your mother Aisha, the most memorizing hadith. Aisha radiallahu anha wa ardaha. But Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who is a sabir, has a patience, he's bent on Allah until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala free her from the skies. Masa'ib, it happened to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam left and right. He never fight with his family. Give me one example. Then you can copy him because you follow the sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. How many of us can take the children on their shoulder and they pray as Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was dealing with Al-Hassan and Al-Husayn? You see it in the masajid, they take the kids out from the line, say, stay in the back. Why he cannot be next to you? He played, it's fine. One day he will understand, straight the line, because that's what we learn. If he's go to the back, how is going to straight his line? How he will understand the line? What is the line is? We are a believers. Four words, my dear brothers and sisters, can make the conclusion and correct ourselves. We all said it every time in our salah after Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. Four words. If you understand these four words, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, everything will be straight in your life. Said it, understanding, feel it. And see how is the reaction from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How He will be very happy with you. How He will let you enjoy your life. How He will let your life get straight. He will let the shaitan away from you. So Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. Said it day and night, my dear brothers and sisters. Enjoyed it in your salah. Understand it when you are sitting to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Please, sisters, before the brothers. Your house is very important. You are the mother. If you control the house, everything would be straight. You are the nation by yourself. You are the mother. We understand our mother Khadija, what she did with Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You are the mother, as Aisha radiallahu anha wa arda, she was very smart, she memorizing the old hadith. You are the mother as Hajar alayhi salam, when she control her nerve and she can find the water for her son as by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give it to her. You are the mother who can do a lot. You're the one who breastfeed. You're the one who Allah give you a lot of sabr. Allah love you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He let you come from Adam alayhi salam. So you are very important in our life. And the brothers, Allah give you the muscle and give you the aql. And the difference between us, in the period of time when she has it, she cannot pray. You have more knowledge in these days than her. You're the one who can control yourself. Please, do your best. If anything happened, my dear brothers and sisters, leave the house for a while. Run to the masjid. Just get some water. Wudu and pray, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will remove everything for you. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to warm our houses. Allahumma aghfir lana zunubana wa kaffir anna sayyatina. Allahumma astir awratana wa awrat al-muslimin. Allahumma aghfir lana ya arhamar rahimin. Allahumma aj'al biyutana amiratan bil-Qur'an, amiratan bil-Rahmah, amiratan bi-sunnati Rasulillah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ya arhamar rahimin, aghfir lana zunub, kaffir anna sayyat, ishfi kulla marid, irham kulli mayit. Allahumma arzuqna sharbata ma'in min yadi rasulika al-karim, la nazma ba'da abada. Allahumma aj'alna من الصابرين على البلاء اللهم اجعلنا من الصابرين على البلاء اللهم اجعلنا من الصابرين على البلاء اجمعنا مع النبيين والصديقين والشهداء في عليين اللهم إن الجنة كتبتها لمن قال لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله فاجمعنا معهم يا كريم اللهم حرم النار على أجسادنا تقبل منا واقبلنا اقبض أرواحنا وأنت راض عنا يا كريم لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إني كنت من الظالمين عباد الله رحمني ورحمكم الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون اذكروا الله العلي العظيم يذكركم وادعوه يستجب لكم وأقم الصلاة.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. والعصر إن الإنسان لفي خسر إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر.